Before implementing the motor upgrade of my CNC version 3.2.2, I'd like to show you all of the components in detail. The old motors had a holding torque of 22 Nm with a phase current of 1.33 amps at 2.8 volts. From my sponsor RS Components I got two options. The first one has 44 Nm of holding torque. The second version 100 Nm. While the old motors managed to move the axis, the torque was in practice a bit low, so I only could operate the machine with low speeds. That's why I decided to use the strong stepper motors now. The maximum phase current is 2.8 amps at 3.2 volts. I'm using ICs type LV8772 as motor drivers, all soldered on prototyping boards. The chips are manufactured with a distance of 1.78 mm between the pins, but the boards I have in stock have a 2.54 mm grid. In prototyping there is, what doesn't fit will be made to fit. By bending the pins. And using pieces of copper wire I managed to build the circuits on my boards. Only a few external components are needed to make the motor driver work, such as 6 capacitors, one is a large electrolytical type to smoothen the input voltage, two 220 milliohms 3 watts resistors operating as current sensors, and finally 6 0.25 watts resistors and a potentiometer. The green LED used to indicate the function of the IC is an extra I have implemented. Cooling power ICs is always a good idea, I'm using aluminum heatsinks. The phase current is adjusted with the potentiometer on the board. The maximum phase current of the IC is 2.5 amps, which is below the limit of the motor, however 1.3 amps are definitely enough to move the axis of the CNC with sufficient torque and speed. Avoid going to the limits to get a long lifetime of your electronics. In total, 3 motors are needed to move the axis that are controlled by a Simatic IoT 2020 from Siemens. The power source is a CTOP PSU100S with an output voltage of 24 volts at up to 20 amps. An old computer power supply as I'm normally using should do the job as well, however I had the opportunity to get this large power supply and that's why I'm using this 24 volts high power solution. The input voltage of the Simatic ranges from 9 to 36 volts, so it works fine with the 24 volts. The pump for the coolant flow is from the windscreen washer of an old car and runs best at far less than 12 volts in continuous operation. That's why I created a circuit using pulse width modulation to lower the input voltage. The Simatic can turn the pump on and off with the power adjusted by the potentiometer on the board. Finally, the spindle motor can be controlled by software. Low power motors can be switched directly by pulse width modulation using a power MOSFET. As a demonstration I'm using a motor with 24 volts and 1.7 amps at maximum input power. In order to switch my 220 volts power spindle I've implemented a relay in a plug socket. The Apache web server is running on the IoT 2020 through which a program written in C is fed with data. With that you can control the machine through a browser interface, here I'm using my smartphone. You can control all axes in either direction. Turn the coolant pump on or off. And switch the spindle with a pulse width signal to adjust the revolution speed. Machine data is transmitted through G-code commands. With the browser interface, you can upload a G-code file to the IoT 2020. The stored commands are processed line by line and the stepper motors, coolant pump or spindle are actuated. In a coming video I will demonstrate what you can do with the upgraded CNC. Have a look at my pages to see on what fares the CNC will be displayed or to get the build instruction and software. Thanks for watching and I'll be back!